Hi, welcome to this Penn Publishing Interactive video. In this video, I'm going to give you some work from home collaboration basics for Microsoft Teams. So let's get started. So if you're not familiar with Microsoft Teams is part of the Office 365 family, and it's a productivity and collaboration tool that can be used online and is very, very popular. It's one of the most popular applications that Microsoft has released in recent memory. So just if you don't have an Office 365 license, know that you need a license to get Microsoft Teams to use to its full capacity. There is a Microsoft Teams version that is free, but it is limiting. So with that being said, just make sure that if you have a Office 365 license, pay attention to what license you have. Depending on your license, you may or may not have Microsoft Teams available. If you don't have an Office 365 license, you know, feel free to contact us. We'd be happy to help you get a license and get you all set up. But with that being said, let's get started with these tips that I have for those that are working from home. So Microsoft Teams is very good because it has a clean interface and you have everything in one place. So the first thing that you need to understand is that you can create different teams. So I already have a team here for our Wichita location, but to create a team, it's very easy. And I am using the Microsoft Teams desktop version application. You can use Microsoft Teams through a browser as well. But for purposes of this video, I'm going to just use the desktop application. So to create a team, all you have to do is be on the Teams tab here, then join or create a team. I'm just going to create a new team, and I'm going to create one for a different location. I'm going to just create Houston team for our Houston location, in our fictitious Houston location, I should say. And then I'm going to hit create. Once I do this, it's going to say nice work. And as you can see here now, it's going to let me add members to my Houston location. I'm going to skip this step for now. But you just know that you can do that there. And now I have two teams. I have my Wichita location, my Houston location, and that those are teams. In here, you'll see that I have this general text here. Those are called channels. So a channel is basically a place that you can have conversations, have files, etc. By default, anytime you create a new team, the general channel will be created. However, if you want to create a new channel, all you have to do is click the ellipses here and add a channel. So channels can be things like if you want to keep everything for the Wichita location's marketing efforts in one channel where people can have conversations, you can save files, you can, you know, just communicate back and forth and collaborate virtually about the marketing efforts for the Wichita location. I'm just going to create the marketing channel here. It's accessible to everyone on my team. And automatically show this channel to everyone's channel list. So I'm going to hit add here. And again, now you can see that my marketing channel has been created. So that's how easy it is to create teams and create channels. And now the next step or the next tip I want to give you is how to easily collaborate on files with Microsoft Teams. All you got to do is, you know, select the channel that you want, obviously the team and then the channel. I'm just going to go off of the general channel here. I'm going to hit files. And the cool thing about Teams is that it's already integrated with all the Office suite products, and you can create a Word document, Excel spreadsheet, a PowerPoint, a OneNote notebook, or forms for Excel that you can collaborate with your team members that are, you know, maybe down the hall or in this situation for these tips. If you're working from home and you have, you know, a team that everyone's working from home or remotely, everyone can collaborate from wherever they are live on a document. So I'm just going to create a document here and say test document. And that's it. So it's just going to create a Word document, and you know, I can start. I mean, as you can see on the interface, it's Word. It's gonna, you know, work and function just like your typical, what you're used to seeing in Microsoft Word. And I'm just gonna put hello world, and so forth. So you have these tools available to you here. You can invite other team members to collaborate with you live and so forth. So it's very easy to collaborate virtually with Teams here. And again, this is just a Microsoft Word document. You can do spreadsheets and so forth. Now, once I do this, you can see it's saved. If I go back to the team, you can see the test document here. You have other options. You can copy the link. You can make this a tab, which, you know, if you have important things that, you know, policies or something that maybe need to be added to this team, you can just make this a tab and it'll show up there. But again, really easy to collaborate on documents, spreadsheets, and so forth with remote team members. So again, that's another cool feature of Microsoft Teams, and it's all in one area. So the next thing I want to show y'all is how to, obviously, when you're remote, you want to communicate with your team members that are remotely. So you have this chat feature. I already have a coworker and she happens to be online. So you can, you know, send files. You can have longer, more detailed conversations. You can even have gifts in here, etc. So it's really easy to, you know, just communicate. What I'm going to show y'all next is she is working remotely today and I am going to give her a call so you can see how that part of Microsoft Teams works and how easy it is to use. And this is just going to be an audio call. If you have a video camera, a webcam or whatever, you can do a virtual meeting and face to face, virtually. But I am just going to simply hit the audio call button and we're going to call Bethany. Hi, Bethany.
Hi.
How are you?
Doing well.
You are live. Well, not live. You're being recorded on this recording, and I'm showcasing how easy it is to make phone calls or audio calls through Microsoft Teams. But how's it going today?
Going well. Working from home.
That's exactly what I'm trying to showcase in this video. But as y'all can see, it's very easy, clear and everything. And we don't have webcams on our setup right now. But if we did, you could also do a virtual meeting face to face, etc. And the other cool thing is you also can have a chat here on the side and so forth. So thank you, Bethany, for taking the call. And I'm going to keep recording here.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you. Bye. And as you can see, that's how easy it is to make the phone call to a team member that's working remotely. But those are just some of the basics and overview, a quick overview of Microsoft Teams and some of the helpful things you can do while you're working remotely at home or in a different location and so forth. I hope this video has been beneficial. I know it's very basic and it gives you a quick overview, but hopefully it, you know, was beneficial and it helped y'all kind of understand some of the cool features of Microsoft Teams. If you have questions or need help with Microsoft Teams or Office 365 licenses, please visit us at penpublishing.com. If you are on social media, Facebook, Twitter, you can find us there. And if you're watching this on YouTube, we'd really appreciate if you subscribed to our channel, as you know, so that way you can get informed when we release more of these videos and helpful tips. Thank you again for watching, and until next time.